In this video, you'll see how to fast-track your business case for AWS with Migration Evaluator, formerly TSO Logic. Organizations of all sizes are migrating hundreds of thousands of applications to AWS. The key to a successful migration strategy is having a business case that can quantify your return on investment before, during, and after migrating each application. Creating a business case on your own can be a time-consuming process that may take weeks and doesn't automatically identify the best deployment and purchasing options. Even the most experienced organizations are likely to create a migration plan based on what's known, rather than what's possible. Migration Evaluator is an assessment service designed to help AWS customers make faster and smarter migration decisions. The service includes a team of experts who can help you define and achieve your migration objective. Examples of migration objectives include exiting a data center, shifting from capital expenses to operating expenses, or changing software licensing strategies. Based on your migration objective, Migration Evaluator builds a data-driven business case for migrating your existing workloads to AWS, automatically recommending the most cost-effective AWS deployment options. The service can deliver up to 80% savings for database workloads and, on average, a 30% reduction in server costs. To get started with Migration Evaluator, navigate to the product page on the AWS site, and then click Start Building Your Business Case. On the page that opens, scroll down and provide your information to request an assessment. Soon after submitting your request, you'll receive an email with an invitation to create an account on the Migration Evaluator website. Provide your email and create a password. Then agree to the terms and sign up. Once you are signed into the site, you can begin your on-premises inventory discovery. To see the methods of discovery available to you, navigate to the Tools page. Here you have two options for providing information on the environments you want to migrate. The first option is to use the on-premises data collector, which you can install in your data center to collect information and report it back to the Migration Evaluator. You can review the provided documentation to learn how to install and operate the collector. Let's return to the Tools page. To deploy the collector, you'll need to follow the rest of the steps here. For now, let's select View and Configure Collectors. On this screen, you can review and access specific information needed to deploy an on-premises data collector in your organization, such as the encryption certificate, the Amazon Simple Storage Service, or Amazon S3, synchronization path where collected data is stored, and access keys. Let's return to the Tools page to review the second option for providing server information. You can import an Excel file. This page provides the Excel inventory template for manually entering information about the environments you want to migrate to AWS. Let's take a look. The Glossary tab provides descriptions of all the fields in the template. The Template tab is where you can provide information on the servers in your environment. When your template is filled out, return to the Tools page in Migration Evaluator to import the file. Select View and Import Files. Then upload your file here. Once you have finished providing your migration data, either through the on-premises connector or a self-reported file, a team of solution specialists at AWS will review the information and reach out to deliver a full business case evaluation for your review. Let's take a quick look at some of the information contained in this sample business case summary. The business case summary includes 5 main sections. In the overview, we can see a count of servers and attached block storage discovered by the agentless collector during the collection period. SQL Server licenses were also discovered by the collector, in addition to environment and application groupings of business data. In the executive summary, we can see that by simply running current workloads on Amazon Elastic Compute Cloud, or Amazon EC2, and Elastic Block Storage, the projected savings would be significant over modeled on-premises infrastructure costs. Additionally, many of the monitored servers were rarely used, providing opportunities to leverage the elasticity of AWS to right-size the workloads as part of the migration. The Data Insights page displays the percentage of time servers were used, environment insights, and licensing details. The pie chart shows that this company's servers were in use less than 50% of the time. In the table, you can see how Windows and Linux workloads were split, and the number of servers that had no detected activity and should be considered for retirement. In the cost modeling section of the business case, we can see 2 3-year savings plans. In the first savings plan, Microsoft licenses are provided by AWS. This report includes the number of SQL Server licenses AWS would provide as part of the cost. In the second savings plan, the company leverages its existing SQL Server licenses on AWS. This report includes the number of SQL Server licenses it would need, as well as the projected cost to pay Microsoft for the licenses. Finally, the business case suggests next steps to help this customer move forward with its migration. You've just seen how to fast-track your business case for AWS in Migration Evaluator. To request a business case assessment, visit the Migration Evaluator website. Thanks for watching. Now it's your turn to try.